total return on munis on a year-to-date basis is right around zero. Not bad when you compare it to about 2% losses of taxable fixed income, indices of investment-grade taxable fixed income, for example. The reason munis have outperformed, even though interest rates have risen, muni issuance has fallen pretty sharply on a year-to-date basis. This is the flip side to the effect of the tax bill last year. Last year, there was a rush to issue ahead of the tax bill. December of last year was a record in terms of gross muni issuance ever ahead of the tax bill. This year, we're giving that back, and issuance has been pretty light. Demand's been okay, and on net, munis have incrementally outperformed. They've richened in fixed income space with muni ratios, generally heading lower for intermediate and shorter term bonds. So year-to-date returns are muted, but they're a little better than taxables. In a world where rates are still rising, we'll count that as a small victory. Okay, the U.S. economy is doing very well. And when the economy is expanding, you see state and local governments benefiting from higher income tax revenues, higher sales tax revenues, as well as higher property tax revenues. All of those factors have helped to repair municipal budgets sharply from where they were a number of years ago as we came out of the very deep recession and had a long, grinding recovery. So the municipal credit picture actually looks pretty good in general. There are pockets of concern, however. So some states, like in New Jersey or in Illinois, where pension funding is very weak, you know, 40% funded ratios, give or take. No rainy day fund for the next slowdown. You have to be concerned there. Maybe not now, because the wind at the back of all states is helping New Jersey and Illinois as well. But they have structural imbalances they haven't really fixed. They have pension problems that they have to address. And they have no rainy day fund for when the economy eventually rolls back into a recession. So near term, the story is generally good. The timing of the next downturn is a question, and it will have varying implications across the credit spectrum. There are some states that are not well positioned for that ultimate day. Tax reform reduced the corporate tax rate sharply. So it was 35% at the federal level. It's now 21. So one of the most salient impacts in this calendar year has been selling from banks. Banks and insurance companies, which pay corporate income taxes and saw a 14 percentage point reduction in their tax rate, have less interest in tax-exempt income. So they've lightened up on their muni allocations, and they've been generally pretty strong sellers of municipal bonds. Individual investors, however, the highest tax bracket went from 39.6 to 37. Pretty modest adjustment. The brackets moved, so some people who might have made $250,000 in a year, they might have moved down a bracket as well. But on net, we have not seen individual investors react to the tax cut nearly as strongly as the corporate investors have. So munis are still in demand when it comes to the individual investor, both in the form of mutual fund flows as well as direct bonds. So demand's held up reasonably well from that party. And the key thing to consider is that issuance on a year-to-date basis is down about 25% compared to where we were at this time over the last 3 years. That's a big drop. So with demand being okay on net and issuance dropping sharply, you know, supply and demand matter everywhere, and they matter in munis too. And that has supported relative performance thus far on the year. As interest rates have backed up, munis have actually outperformed a little bit.